Welcome to a lesson on integrating functions of two variables. We can integrate functions of two variables in a similar way we determine partial derivatives of a function of two variables, meaning if integrating with respect to x, we'll treat y as a constant, and if integrating with respect to y, we'll treat x as a constant. Let's see what happens when we take a function, find its first order partials, and then integrate with respect to x as well as with respect to y. So if we're given the following function in two variables, the partial derivative of f with respect to x would be 9x squared, this would be 0, this would be minus 1, this would be y, and this would be 0. So here's the partial of f with respect to x. Now let's go ahead and see if we recover the function if we integrate this partial derivative with respect to x. So we'd have 9 times x to the third over 3 minus x plus, again, treating y as a constant, this would give us y times x. Let's go ahead and simplify this.
We have 3x cubed
minus x plus xy. Now, if we compare this antiderivative with the original function in two variables, notice we don't recover the entire function. We're missing this term here as well as this term here. So instead of just putting plus c like we normally do when integrating functions of one variable, we're going to put plus c of y to make sure that we recognize that we may not have recovered the entire function in terms of y. Now let's determine the partial of f with respect to y. Here we'd have 0. Here we'd have 8 over y cubed. This would be 0. This would be plus x. And this would be plus 2. Remember, we're treating x as a constant. And now we're going to integrate this with respect to y, again, treating x as a constant. So here we'd have 8 times y to the negative 2 divided by negative 2 plus, again, x is a constant, so we'd have x times y, and this would be plus 2y. Let's go ahead and simplify this. This would be negative 4 over y squared plus xy plus 2y. Comparing this function to the original function, notice again we're missing some of the x terms, so our constant of integration will be c of x. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have a definite integral of a function of two variables, and what I want you to notice here is that we're integrating with respect to x, but the limits of integration are in terms of y. This will be important later on. So because we're integrating with respect to x, we're going to treat y as a constant. So here we're going to have 2 times x squared over 2. And then treating y as a constant, we'll have minus 3y times x. And then we have our limits of integration. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We're going to have x squared minus 3xy. And because we integrated with respect to x, we're going to replace x with 2y and 0. So we'll have 2y squared minus 3 times 2y times y. And over here, x is going to be 0, so we'll have 0 here and 0 here. So we're going to have 4y to the second. This is going to be minus 6y squared. So the result is negative 2y squared. Let's take a look at another example. Here we're integrating with respect to y, so we'll treat x as a constant. And again, notice our limits of integration are in terms of x when we integrate with respect to y. So if x is a constant, we're trying to find the antiderivative of 1 over y. That's going to be natural log y. So our antiderivative is x squared natural log y. And we'll evaluate this at 2x and 1. And again, because we integrate with respect to y, we're replacing y with 2x and y with 1. So we're going to have x squared natural log 2x minus x squared natural log 1. Well, natural log 1 is equal to 0, so we're left with x squared natural log 2x. And notice we have a function in terms of x now. Now that we've integrated functions in two variables, I want to give you a preview of where we're headed. Now that we can integrate a function of two variables, we will begin a study of the integral of an integral, or a double integral, also called an iterated integral. So if we take an integral of an integral, what we're going to do is evaluate the inner integral first, and then evaluate the outer integral. So as you can see from this notation below, this is what a double integral looks like. So if in this form, what we're going to do is integrate with respect to y first, and then integrate with respect to x. And if it's in this form, we'll integrate with respect to x first, and then with respect to y. So I'll work our way inside out. And I'd like to finish by talking about the connection between integrating a function of one variable and a double integral of a function of two variables. We know from Calc 1, if we integrate a continuous non-negative function on the interval from a to b, as we see here, it'll give us the area under the curve bounded by the x-axis on the given interval. Well, now if we extend this to a function of two variables that is continuous and non-negative over a region in the xy plane, it'll give us the volume bounded by the xy plane and the surface defined by f of xy. Now this is a lot of new notation. This is telling us we're going to find the double integral over a specified region in the xy plane of a function of two variables. Notice here it states we're integrating with respect to a. Well, this really represents either dx dy or dy dx based upon whether we will integrate with respect to x first or with respect to y first. So we'll talk a lot more about this in the next several videos, but I wanted to mention the connection between integrating a function of one variable and determining a double integral of a function of two variables. Thank you for watching.